Hi, in today's video, we are going to discuss Paul White. And I haven't seen a lot of videos on this guy, but he definitely used the power of thoughts to create his lottery win. Now, Paul White won $149 million in the lottery, but he did it intentionally and somewhat unintentionally at the same time. You see, not all of us know about the law of attraction. But it's always working for us. And so what Paul White did, as you'll see in the interview, is he always believed, he always knew that he was going to win. He even said, I went through this in my head so many times in my life that it's weird that it's finally happening. So let's give the interview a watch, and then we'll discuss some things afterwards. Enjoy.
It's crazy. I got to tell you, I've said it a couple of times today. I've gone through this in my head so many times in my life that you almost feel like it's finally coming true, because I'm sure anybody who's ever bought a lottery ticket thinks about what they're gonna do with the money the next day and all the people they can help, and you know, and so I feel like it's almost been coming. I really do. My siblings have given me grief for years about how I talk about I'm gonna win the lottery someday, and actually, we just got together not so long ago for my dad's 80th birthday, and we were playing this game. I don't remember the gist of it exactly, but you had to pick who in the crowd would match this description, and the description was, their financial plan consists of playing the lottery. Well, everybody picked my name, and they thought it was funny then. Who's right now? That's what I want to say.
So who's laughing now? Isn't that funny? How he envisioned winning the lottery so much that he talked about it. He gave off the energy of it so much that his family, his friends, considered him to be, you know, the lottery winner. And even if it's in a joking manner, you're still giving off that vibration. And so you can really tell when you're giving off the vibration of something you want when other people notice it about you before you even have it. Let's keep watching.
You know, the big stuff you don't think about, I feel this pressure off my shoulders that you carry every day with you. I have two kids. Are my kids, am I gonna be able to pay for them to go to college? Am I gonna be able to, you know, take care of them if they have health issues? All these things, gone. You don't ever have to worry about it again. It's amazing, so.
You know, it's kind of funny, but I wanna point out, you notice how he said all of his money worries are gone. He feels this like weight lifted off of his shoulders. I think that's very important, because if that's what he's feeling now, that is the vibration of the amount of money he has. So for a lot of you trying to manifest winning, you know, millions of dollars or hundreds of millions of dollars, yeah, focus on winning, focus on the money part, but also focus on the relief that you would feel and would feel or will feel when you win, that you don't have to worry about bills no more. You don't have to worry about your house mortgage or your car payments or anything like that. And focus on that relief and how that feels, that relief. And incorporate that into your visualizations and incorporate that into your daily life of just feeling this relief that all is well, you've made it, it's done. And I think that's really important.
Paul, tell us that story again last night. I went out randomly last minute saying, I gotta go buy some tickets. Tell
yeah, I had forgotten on my way home. We were getting prepared for the weekend, basically. And Kim's mother is visiting, and she has a, I think it's a brand new Mustang, isn't it? And she has a 16-year-old son, just like I do. And he loves every chance to be able to drive the car. And I said, oh, I forgot to get my Powerball tickets. He said, well, we can take Grandma's car. So she said, okay. So we drove up, and about 8:30, I think, I bought $10 worth of tickets and didn't think anything about it until this morning. And Kim called me at like 8:30. She said, are you a millionaire yet? And I said, I'm so busy, I don't have time to look. And she said, well, I think the Powerball was 32. Well, I always pay attention to my Powerball, and I had two 32s out of the five numbers. And I thought, oh, was the next number 59? And she said, I think it was. She didn't have it up in front of her at this point. And then she said, I think five was in there too. And I said, oh my God, I have five too. But I'm really busy. We have to do this later. I have work to do. I can't deal with this right now. She's like, no, we already know you have three numbers. We have to go through them now. So we went through them. And sure enough, they were right. And I said, I'll have to call you back later. And I went, woo! Ran around the office. And everybody's like, oh my God, what happened? What happened? So I think I had 10 people verify the ticket before I left the office. They all got to hold it. So.
Take pictures of it.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool stuff.
Another thing is, you notice how his wife or his girlfriend or whoever this Kim girl is called him and said, are you a millionaire yet? And he also implied that, oh, I didn't get my Powerball tickets yet the day before. And so what this is telling me, and what this should tell you, is that he is a frequent player. He not only visualized winning unintentionally, but he did it in a consistent manner. He played. You see, a lot of us will visualize, we'll play a few times, and then we'll quit. And you have to give the universe time, you know? And it's not going to happen the exact way that you think it's going to happen. It's going to be some little deviations. And it might not be the first, you know, 5 times or 10 times or 20 times. But it could be 21. But what if you gave up after 20? So if you want anything in your life, including the lottery, you need to play consistently.
I told you I've been waiting for this day my entire life. Not waiting. They already told me I gotta wait 2 weeks for my money, for God's sake. Start the clock right now.
I've been waiting for this moment my entire life. I think that sums it up, guys. This guy, Paul White, literally visualized himself winning the lottery without knowing, at least I believe, without knowing the power of his thoughts. And you can say all you want, everyone believes that they're going to win. And that's not true. If you look, people will buy so many tickets and then they'll talk about the odds. Like, oh, I'm so, you know, I hope I win, but I probably won't, you know. And most people don't think like that, guys. Most people buy tickets and they doubt. Or they buy tickets and they never visualize. And is it possible for them to win? Of course it is, because I believe that we live in the chance reality. But I also believe that the more you focus on something, the more you want something, the more you put a laser focus intention on something, you lower those odds. And so eventually, if you stick to that, you will get whatever it is that you want. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video as much as I did. And I really like this guy's energy. He's funny and he's stuck to something. And I hope that whatever you guys are visualizing, maybe it's not the lottery, maybe it's something else, but whatever it is, I hope you stick to it. And if you do, you will eventually manifest it into your life. As long as you don't focus on the doubts or the fears, or as long as you don't focus on not doing any action, because you still got to go buy the ticket, you know? So focus on your desire, have a schedule, keep doing it, be consistent. And stay at it until it happens. You have to be delusionally positive about your desire. So that pretty much sums it up, guys. Comment down below who you want to see next. And as always, thank you for watching.